Welcome to that moment in the show where we celebrate your endeavour with a thread. Before we go to this week's happy couple, let's have a look at who greeted the judge this time last week in the bug house, Roy.
Yes, Paul and Heather, HG, here they are. They had the night at the Lucas Heights Motel. They loved it. The bar fridge was just extraordinary. Then we had the hidden camera to see what those kiddies got up to. Lights out, next morning, off to the nuclear reactor. They didn't know what to expect. They certainly weren't expecting something that looked a little like the Mir space station some years ago. It was very futuristic, very clean. That's your nuclear reactor right there down there in the middle. They were taken down, shown how to drop an isotope in. They could fiddle around with some isotopes there. It'll show you how difficult it is. I met a bloke who's obviously spent too much time there. Check for radiation. They didn't have much on them. And then it was off to the cafeteria for a toasted sandwich.
It's living.
Ah, those kids.
Oh, what a marvellous time. And they live to tell the tale. This week the prizes include the Club Buggery card, the Ian Turpie CD, plus the Nissan Cedric's Going for a Song, and this wonderful, wonderful record from the archives here at the ABC. This is really living. It's a wonderful record. And notice what I like about this is four Athol guys together there. It's a quarter of the Seekers times four, and a tremendous effort there from the Salvation Army. This is really living.
It's a real listening record.
It is, yes. Really enjoy it.
Yes, as well, HG, tonight's happy couple get to appear on the last show in Australia of Club Buggery, for this season at least, and say, that was living.
Wow. That is That was living.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I love the gear. You decided on red yourself.
Yes.
Yep, and your name is?
Udo.
Udo and?
Maureen.
Udo and Maureen, the blue and the red. It's a knight's colours, isn't it?
That's right.
You're going for the knights tomorrow?
Yes, definitely.
The Newcastle Knights.
Yes.
Congratulations.
We're on the Central Coast.
The Central Coast. Not too far from the Knights. You'll be welcoming Norths next year. And then the Central Coast Norths. There you go. There's the product shot. Enjoy it because...
That was living.
Well done.
Last week we set the nation a stumper. Roy, what was it and how did the nation respond?
Which TV station smells the most? I think it was HG. Yes. 10, 7 ABC, Fox Office, SBS, Channel 9. How did it go? Channel 9 by heaps! Followed by 7, 10, it looks like Fox and Optus drew, and ABC came out of it pretty well, along with SBS. Funny that.
Did you?
That was before the Farrah Fawcett show, though, I think.
Right. 7 might have
crept in.
Now, did you vote, Roy?
I did, yes.
And sadly, we come to the end
for
of another...
Fox.
For Fox, did you?
Yeah, I did. That surprises me. Yeah. I looked over your voting sheet and I thought, oh, he's going to go for 7.
Yeah, then settle on Fox. Now, sadly, we come to the end of another series of Club Buggery in Australia. Roy, where are you off to in the coming weeks?
HG, I thought we might go to the United Kingdom and pick some fights.
Yes.
Yes. And hopefully turn that into a television program.
Fairly easy. When do these come on in Australia, Roy?
When is it?
The first 3 weeks of November.
November.
Yes,
yeah.
It's Fight Night here at the ABC. Fight Night from the old dart. And obviously, Roy and myself will be pulling on the gloves and going round by round with some locals.
Yes. It'd be good if we could get those Holyoke kids on.
Oh, it would be good. Yeah, the old Australians.
The old Australians.
The Australians, yes. Mm. As we sign off from the sharp end, Roy and I would like to thank John Wood, Glenn McGrath, the Nissan Cedric's, Kate Sobrano, the brand new Beatles, Ian Turpie, and you, the audience, whether here in the sharp end or there at home on the spot, bot and pot. Thanks once again for taking an interest in variety. Finally, it's time to, in this Festival of the Boot weekend, it's time to talk winners. And let's talk about winners of the 1997 Battle of the Sounds. And the nominations are, and remember Australia, these are your votes. The nominations are, number one, Thelma Houston, Don't Leave Me This Way. Number two, Ian Turpie, Smells Like Teen Spirit. Three, Billy Thorpe, Most people I know think that I'm crazy. Drum roll, please. Envelope. Thanks very much, Price Waterhouse, for tabulating the results. And the national winner of the Battle of the Bands is Ian Turpie and smells like Ian Turpie. Indeed, you can watch it all night and not get tired of it. And tonight, your battle winner is back with a little help from his friends. And his friends on this occasion are the brand new Beatles and the Nissan Cedrics Australia. Welcome back, your 1997 battle winner. Come on down, Ian Turps Turpie. See you in November, where we shout cooey from the front bar once again.
What would you do if I sang out a tune? Would you stand up and walk out on me? Lend me your ears and I'll sing you a song. And I'll try not to sing out of key. If I get a little bit of help. Someone to love. We'll be right back.
someone to love.
Thank God for the time machine.
Oh, where are we?
This is amazing. This is the studio. This was our set.
The Club Buggery set?
Yes. Oh, the memories. This is just how it was.
It looks so ordinary.
Oh, where did the Sedgwick stand?
Just here.
Oh, yes. And the band?
Over there. Hey, look. There's my old guitar.
Oh, wow.
Incredible.
Oh, play something for us, Terps.
Yeah, show us the magic.
You give your hand to me, and then you say goodbye.
And we can hardly speak, but you're that lucky guy.
And though you wished me well,
they just couldn't tell.
No, you don't know me. I never knew the art of making love, though my heart aches with love for you.